You are very welcome back to the program. It's the Sport Matters and Super Screen Television, and you're welcome to the program. It's the start of the program anyway. Joel Nwakego.
Good to be here. It's a Monday edition of Sport Matters. Sport Lovers, also good to be here too. My weekend was fine, like you asked. Mine was okay.
The Man City, they're back to winning ways after the disappointment of the Champions League.
Well, you know, when you lose a game like that, all the annoyance you pour into your opponent. Exactly what they did to Newcastle. All the annoyance, the grievances, you know, I mean, the
and phobia, it was a thumping.
It was massive. But good one for Man City.
And the allegation, coming from Pep Guardiola, that the whole of England is backing Liverpool to win the title.
No, but it's true. Liverpool is England. England is Liverpool.
We'll surely come back. We'll surely come back to that. I have with me Adebayo Bailo. He's a FIFA license agent and a developer of talent, if you want to put it that way, of Igomo FC. Adebayo, welcome to Sports Matters on Super Screen Television.
Thank you very much.
To really start, because, you know, when we talk about football development from the grassroots, what is the most important in that, you know, a club like Igomo FC consider most important?
Here we consider how the players progress is, and we also look at continuity when it comes to these players. Okay. Because most times what we don't have going forward is players coming out, and at the end of the road you see that they don't progress
beyond
a certain
level.
Extent. So you have these players, we put them together, those that really wanted to work hard, and these players, they work.
Okay.
As you're working, you grow, and we integrate you into other things too.
Oh, okay. I could remember very well, there was a championship that Igomo FC took, young player like under 12, under 13 to out there in Japan, and actually won that tournament for the first time, by any African, country.
Yeah.
The progress of those players, where are they right now?
Some of them, those, like I said, there should be a continuity.
Okay.
And so bulk of those players are still at Igomo FC. They are at the senior team too.
Okay, you mean players in that 2019 team,
yeah,
under 12 that went to Japan,
yeah,
they are in Igomo FC first team right now?
Yes, they are in first team. And so
we're just talking about 3 years down the lane now.
Yes.
You mean 16, 15-year-old player is playing for Igomo FC right now?
Yes, they are. Because you have these players working closely with coaches who want to see their progresses, and when you integrate them into the senior team, these ones are really, really doing well. Mind you, there are competitions from older players,
okay,
and so this will make these younger ones to have such hearts
to aspire to do more.
Yeah.
From findings, we're told that tournament, that such magnitude of that tournament, was the same tournament, FC Barcelona saw a player like Ansu Fati, which is also a good one.
And that Japanese young, Kubo.
Yeah.
So, with that, what does it translate to for the young players that you took to Japan?
Yeah. For these young ones, we have, since they went there, they won the competition. There is high demand for them to come back, which is either for scholarship, so that these ones can really grow in a better facility and then do well.
Mm.
And so we have these how do we call it? We have this partnership,
okay,
for these young ones to go there, back, and then study while they play football. And so before you know it, at a certain age, they will have their professional contract signed.
Information got to me that you have, is it two or four players that are out there in scholarship right now as we are speaking in the studio?
Yeah, two of them, they traveled last week.
Okay.
Yeah.
To where?
To Japan.
Whoa.
And so two of them, they are there now, and we are looking forward to because in the same team over there where they will be playing their football, we have other Nigerians too there.
Oh, okay. Like but that, they are not from Igamo FC.
Yeah, no, they are not from Igamo FC. Oh, okay. But you have these older players that they can look forward to.
The acclimatization will even be much easier for them, seeing their fellow countrymen.
Yes, people like Otaka. Otaka plays for
Otaka.
Yes. Okay. Peter Otaka.
Really?
Yes, the younger brother.
He still plays and he's the leading goal scorer out there
in Japan.
J-League. Yes, J-League right now. And so J-League is very strong in terms of even in their Champions League and all of that. So they have these
players. The Asian Champions League.
Yes. So they are looking at these older players to at least to help them acclimatize very well. But these players, yeah.
Now let me ask this. You know, it's key. Such questions are always key. Are we going to have a situation where these players will come back and represent Nigeria, or we're going to see them playing for other nationals? Because we have a situation where Nigerian players go abroad and they tell us, look, I'm not a Nigerian, because being exposed to good facilities and all that. So what is going to be obviously doing in order to bring this player back and represent the country, I mean, the bigger stage?
Yeah, it's good that people who are managing them outside football, like what our own company does, Hyper Sports, we help these young ones to, you know, to play football while we take care of other things outside football.
For them.
For them.
Mm, okay.
And so that is why we are managing them. And so, like these young ones, you're still open to them. They're still open to playing for their fatherland. Mm. They cherish this country very much. And so if you have them while doing other things for them to concentrate on football, then they'll see the national team, any of the age group, either the national or the under 20, the under 17, they'll see to be something massive for their career. Wow. And Nigeria is a very talented country.
Wow. That's something that is key, you know, and FIFA always consider that very, you know, very, very important in the sense that when you have a young player leaving their country, they need the consent of their player or their parents. How did Hyper Sport manage that?
Most young players that are there, we have the consent of their parents.
Did any of their parents follow them down to Japan?
No, for now no. Just like every other player, it will get to a time where they will have to invite their parents.
Okay.
But right now, they have a foster parents, and the owner of Igamo.
Foreign foster parents?
Yeah, no. The foster parent, like the owner of Igamo, will be there with them.
Okay.
To
okay.
see that everything goes really well.
And who's this person? Who's this person?
He is Egbayilo Abayomi, the owner of Igamo.
Oh, okay. So, I remember we had him in his studio some time ago. Okay.
So he's always there with them and, you know, so that everything works smooth. Okay. Not going to dump people's children somewhere in the name of football. At the end of the day, you don't have account for this one. So he's like a father figure to them, each and every one of them.
No, that's fantastic. Well, in the what position is the Igamo FC on the league table for National League One?
Yeah, right now they are third. Smart City is at first position. Yeah, and I think Synergy or Utility, one of them is second. While we are third, we are at same points.
Okay, just same by point. Goal difference.
Yeah, goal difference, just one goal difference. So.
Okay.
Now, if I have to ask this, Igamo FC, we know where it came out from Orele.
Yeah.
Anybody know where Orele is and all that, you know, and they feel Orele is one bad area in Lagos. But right now, it seems like Igamo FC coming out of that, you know, area. How did you guys manage to do it, you know, bringing these players to that position, you know, trying to make Orele what it is, I mean, better, at the same time, you know, putting Orele on the world map? Because I like it or not, those players are representing the entire Orele
brand
out there in Japan. So, how did you manage to make really what it is today?
First and foremost, we all came out from there, and we have great minds that have come out from that community. And so you don't look at how you see the place, like, how do I put it? Yeah, it might be bad to people, but you have great minds in there. just that the opportunities are not there. Mm-hmm. And so when you have opportunity, then you can bring what you have out, then showcase it. And that is exactly what we were doing. Mm-hmm. And so for Orile and Environ, Orile, come down to Ajegunle, come down to Surulere, everywhere, you come down to Igomo, and we try to bring out the best talents of younger ones, then we nurture them.
So, in other words, Igomo FC happens to be the ambassador of this, you know, Igomo and really, and you know, and the environs.
Yeah.
You know, it's good like that. When you know, this is what we talk about when it comes to, you know, grassroots development. Mm. I would have been much happier if I see Igomo FC and, you know, corporate organizations sponsoring them to go and participate in this, because there is one competition that's always very attached to my heart, the Slum World Cup. You know about
yeah,
that?
Yeah.
I don't know. Probably I have to talk to Abayo or Mbailo on this if they can participate in this, because okay. You know the World Cup. I mean, Slum World Cup in Slum has grown to, you know, to become something that the world attention is on it right now, and the corporate organizations are like, you know, dedicating and, you know, investing a lot in it, not because of anything. It's because when you have people taken away from the small slum, they will shun vices, there will be peace in the community, and these people will also become a model for others that are still in the slum to know that, fine, you are here today, but you can be where we are tomorrow.
I always want to ask this question. Now we heard Abayomi Agbayelo has been involved in other things, like, you know, he's a philanthropist, so to speak, and not just being the CEO of Igomo FC. Can you tell us a bit more about him and his exploits in Japan? And, I mean, transcends to Nigerian football.
He does other things. And
other things like?
He does, like, if we say he's a philanthropist, he has other business too that he's doing right here. Down here, so he doesn't go out there. He didn't just go out there to say, "Yeah, I'm making the money and I'll just have to be there." Mm. So he comes down here, employ people, you know, give them means of livelihood, and at the end of the day, he still come down to them, even their families. He also has this initiative to give those at Orile, you know, this opportunity to learn a trade.
Well,
any trade of yours, and he will give you a token while you're going to work.
Wow.
At the end of the day, he would also get material for you, set you up, then you can go.
And when you still have such people in the world,
there is no greater calling than public service.
Yes.
And especially for someone that is doing it as an individual away from, you know, government authority, this is what we need to, you know, this is the kind, you know, these are the kind of people that we need to hype, we need to tell about their exploit to the world. Abayomi Agbayelo, we still appreciate having you in the studio. You know, when you come back to Nigeria, we have your person here, Adebayo Agbayelo, and you need to understand, you know, that what they are doing with their company iPassport and Igomo FC, from the first team down to the, you know, to under 12, under 15, under 17. We just want to say we really appreciate your effort, and, you know,
thank you.
May God continue to bless you guys. Having you here. Please stay with us. You know, the program continues. When we come back, we get into the program fully. We'll be looking at, you know, the result of the MPFL over the weekend, what is happening to Lobby's, Lobby United and Heartland. I don't think there is any heart in that land anymore. When we come back, we'll be looking at that. Stay tuned.